All right, we will begin with some opening thoughts from them, Coach.
We're excited. You know, it's a proud moment for Quinnipiac University hockey program, and just real proud of my guys. And I don't think it was our best game of the year. I don't think we played perfect, but we battled and found a way to score some goals and got that nice lead early. Again, we had some struggles defensively, but the heart was great again. I thought he was the best player on the ice today. I thought we did a nice job in front of him. We probably cleaned up a few things, but you saw why Eric Hartzell's in the Hobie Baker hat trick right now. So again, real proud of my guys. They competed hard, they battled hard. It's a great group of guys. It's been a great ride, and we got to get one more.
Questions for the players?
Ryan Farrell, Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network. Jordan, just talk about the first couple of minutes there. You almost seemed possessed with those first couple of shifts.
We had the overtime there in the game before, and obviously it's kind of expected that it could be a little bit of a letdown, so I just wanted to come out there and just get right to my game, be strong on the walls and strong around the net, and kind of just set the pace to get myself in the game, get my team into the game too.
Okay, further questions?
Matt Popchuk, KDK Radio. As big as it was to get the early 2-0 lead, was there an even greater feeling of being in control when you killed off the penalty and then you go up 3-0 right after?
Zach?
That was a huge break for us. Sways the momentum back on our side from there just after that kill, and scoring the goals, just adds a little more momentum to the game. And 3-0 in the first period is a pretty good lead and gave us a lot to work with.
Further questions for the players? Okay.
Andy Merritt from the New England Hockey Journal. Jordan, coming back to your plays, the first goal is a wraparound. The second goal is another wraparound where you just lose the puck. Is that one of those things where you see that play is there? Did you kind of get a sense that this is something we might be able to go to the well for a couple of times?
Yeah, for sure. I felt like I had some good jump in the beginning, and a lot of guys won battles. I mean, for the first goal, Goody won a battle, which allowed me to get the puck, and I jammed it. And the second goal is the same. I got in there and Art won a battle and allowed me to put the puck on net, and he cashed in on the goal. So, it was there. Guys won the battles.
In the back.
Rick Houston, NCAA.com. Guys, you are one game away from a national hockey championship. What do you do from now until then to keep from getting nervous about that game?
Jeremy.
I think we're just going to keep doing what we've been doing. I'm sure the coaching staff will do a good job of preparing us for Saturday. And I think if we play the way that we'd like to, that'll definitely benefit us. And I know everyone will be excited, and I think we just want to use those nerves towards the game.
Is that good?
Zach?
Okay, Zach?
Another question again.
What are you going to do to keep from being nervous?
Well, we just got to focus on the game. I mean, we're going to be nervous. It's the largest crowds we've ever played in front of, and just got to ease that excitement. It's a little extra in our step, and hopefully it helps us in the game.
Obviously it's a great opportunity. It's a blessing to have this opportunity, but in reality it's the same game we've played since we were 6 or 7 years old. So, we keep that in mind. I think the nerves will go away.
Jen Menendez, Pittsburgh Post-Gazette. Jordan, how would you describe your rivalry with Yale? And obviously you get to play them now. And how would you describe how that's gone this year and then in previous years?
This is my first year in the rivalry, and it's awesome. It's something that the school really rallies around. It's usually our biggest game all year. They're a really good team, and I think we play a really entertaining game when we play them because we're so close. So it's definitely really exciting to play them anytime.
Good.
Julie
Ruppenheimer,
Hockey Buzz. Guys, can you just talk a little bit about the support you're getting from your students, both here and on campus?
Zach?
Well, you can see the stands tonight was full of yellow, which is awesome to see. The buzz on campus the last few weeks has been incredible. You walk around and everyone wants to talk to you, everyone's saying congratulations, teachers,
teachers are talking about it in class. It's been real incredible in our school. It's huge over the past years where we didn't do as well. People have really rallied behind us this year.
Jeremy.
Yeah, I think it's great. Our fan base has just been amazing on the run that we've been on this year. And I know they're very excited for us to get to this point. We want to win one more game.
Jordan.
Yeah, just kind of repeating what they said. It's really exciting. It's something that kind of rallies the student body together. I mean, obviously it's exciting for us, but it's exciting for the teachers, the students, the administration, everyone who's a part of Quinnipiac University. It's definitely exciting for the whole Quinnipiac family.
Further questions for the players? Okay, your comments,
Sam. Sam Warner, Pittsburgh Post-Gazette. Guys, you know, any sense of pride heading into Saturday at all ECAC championship game? You know, your league maybe might get disrespected sometimes, but when are you guys going to take home the trophy?
Jordan.
To be honest with you, I'm not really looking at it as an ECAC thing. I mean, for Saturday night, I mean, where it's going to be Quinnipiac versus Yale, and we hope to end up on top. I think we're just kind of trying to stay focused on the game itself, to not really get wrapped up on everything else that can surround the game and what it means for the league.
Jeremy.
Yeah, I think it makes for definitely a good story, teams being so close in proximity. But like Jordan said, once it comes to game time, I don't think it really matters what league you're in or anything like that. It's just two teams going at it, and we look forward to it.
Zach, you want to jump in on that?
I just think it's good for the league, but when it comes down to it, it's just two teams, and we want to win.
All right, anything else for the players? Okay, guys, we'll let you go. Thanks very much. Congratulations.
Maybe picking just a picking up the segue from those last comments about the ECAC, all the ECAC. It's been quite a while, and there must be some level, if you will, excitement about the fact that this league that maybe is looked upon as the WCHA hockey, the Eastern CCHA has been, is now in the final two teams.
Yeah, I think it's phenomenal for our league. I think the ECAC was one of the best, if not the best league in the country this year. Top to bottom, we're as good as anyone. You know, I think sometimes a couple of the bigger teams will have Thomas Vanek of the world, and obviously he's gone, but you know, those type of players, and we might not get as many of those kids, but we have great players in our league, top to bottom. We have great student athletes, great character. We play hard. You saw that tonight. You saw Yale do that tonight. And I think it's a credit to our league. Our league was awesome all year. You know, you look at us, why we were number one in the pairwise, it's our success and our league success. You know, we not only were one in the pairwise, no one was even a close second. I think we could have lost four more in a row at the end, we would have won it. And that's, you know, for us, for any team to make the NCAAs, you need to win and you need your league to win. And I think we did that all year long and top to bottom. You know, and I said it, I don't remember the interview earlier in the year, but it was one of the XM radio interviews I did. And you know, I said, the worst team in our league can beat the number one team in the country. And I didn't even know who the worst team was at that time. At that point, I think St. Lawrence was struggling. They were tied for last. And they had just beaten, you know, one of the top teams in the country or something. So it's, you know, it's always, again, top to bottom. We're a great league, and I think you're seeing that this year. And now we're, Union did a great job last year. And we've got some good teams.
Jordan.